just few MCQs. Let's go through this. This is question number one. A 32-year-old, hold on. क्या है यार ये, क्यों ही मूव कर रहा है ये, हैं? क्यों नहीं आता, हटता ही, छोड़ दो, बाद में करेंगे, लीव इट. ओके, दिस क्वेश्चन इज अ 32-year-old कंप्यूटर ऑपरेटर क्या करें? अबे यार तुम कसम से, यहां से. ओके, लुक हियर नाउ, दिस क्वेश्चन नंबर वन. अ 32-year-old कंप्यूटर ऑपरेटर कंप्लेन्स ऑफ फीलिंग ऑफ पिंस एंड नीडल्स इन द राइट एंड little finger in the right hand, in the ring and little fingers, which has now progressed to burning pain in the wrist and hand, followed by decreased sensations in the ring and little fingers. However, the back of the hand is having normal sensations. The patient has difficulty in performing the fist, is forming the fist on the ulnar side of the hand. The most probable diagnosis is. Read the question yourself, it will be better. Okay, let me see what are the responses from your side. B, C, A. B, B. Only I think... यादवी, आकाश, अंकिता, संजना. सो द आंसर इज गोएंस कैनाल सिंड्रोम. ओके, सो व्हाट इज हैपनिंग हियर, लेट्स गिव इट अ फास्ट रीडिंग. अ कंप्यूटर ऑपरेटर रेस्ट हिज हैंड, यू नो, रेस्ट हिज हैंड, हिज और हर हैंड on the table while working on a computer, or when you raise, you keep your hand on a mouse. So when you keep your hand on a mouse, obviously you are working on a hard surface. So your ulnar board of the hand is in contact with the table, right? And if you're in a habit of professionally occupied with this work for, like, you know, for 5 hours daily, so with a prolonged course of time, if you remember the course of ulnar nerve, remember, it was reaching into the palm by passing lateral to the pisiform and just adjacent to the pisiform, passing superficial to the flexor retinaculum enclosed by the volar carpal ligament, and the canal formed was Quinn's canal. So when a nerve is in close approximation or intimately related to a bone, and with prolonged compression, there are chances of, you know, nerve compression. So it's this thing what is happening here, because they have written the occupation of the person, one thing. And then if you remember, there was a palmar carpal branch of ulnar nerve, cutaneous branch, and a dorsal cutaneous branch. So the dorsal cutaneous branch of the ulnar nerve passes dorsally before the ulnar nerve enters the Gwen's canal. So in the question, if you remember, they said that there was no loss of sensation on the dorsal side of the hand. Only thing was the loss of sensory sense, loss of paresthesia on the your pins and needle sensations on the little finger and the ring finger, and these are signs of nerve compression. Thick. So a computer operator rests her side of a hand on a hard surface for a prolonged time using when you're using a mouse. So there are chances of ulnar nerve compression at the wrist joints, that is called Gwen's canal syndrome, producing above symptoms. While in ulnar nerve entrapment or above the elbow, yani ki jo nerve entrapment neuropathy, do changes ho sakti ulnar nerve ki, because ulnar nerve is in contact. Whenever a nerve is intimately in relation to a bone, there are always such questions asked because there are chances, because nerve, on outside is epineurium and the bone on outside is periosteum. Both are dense fibrous connective tissue. So epineurium, when approximated with periosteum, under pressure for a long time, they might, adhere or tether to each other, right? That's called entrapment neuropathy. So while in ulnar nerve entrapment, it also winds behind the medial epicondyle of humerus, and that's called, bounded by a fibrous, band, and that's called cubital tunnel syndrome. Thick. And एक थोरैसिक आउटलेट सिंड्रोम भी होता है. थोरैसिक आउटलेट सिंड्रोम, इफ यू रिमेंबर, दैट वाज रिलेटेड विद टू थिंग्स, एंड दैट वाज द सर्वाइकल रिब एंड अदर फैक्टर इन व्हिच वाज प्लेइंग अ रोल इन थोरैसिक आउटलेट सिंड्रोम वाज द एनोमलस इंसर्शन ऑफ स्क्लेनियस एंटीरियर, व्हिच माइट हैव अ बाइफिडेड इंसर्शन ऑन द फर्स्ट रिब, एंड इट्स द लोअर ट्रंक ऑफ ब्रेकियल प्लेक्सस व्हिच टेक्स which will have to take a high jump. Normally it crosses the first rib to enter into the axilla, but in case of sixth rib, it will have to take a high jump, or in case of splitted insertion of sclenius anterior, might also compress the lower trunk, and lower trunk is C8T1, and that is the spinal segment involved in ulnar nerve as well. तो इन दोनों जगहों पे भी इंट्रैपमेंट हो सकता है, एंड देयर आर सिमिलर फीचर्स इंक्लूडिंग सेंसरी लॉस ऑफ द मीडियल हाफ ऑन द डॉर्सल ऑफ द हैंड एंड पैरालिसिस ऑफ द फ्लेक्सर कार्पाई अल्नारिस, डिफिकल्टी इन अडक्टिंग द रिस्ट. हाउएवर इन कार्पल टनल सिंड्रोम देयर इज पैरालिसिस ऑफ थिनार ग्रुप ऑफ मसल्स, राइट? तो डिफरेंस हो गया ना, इसमें थिनार ग्रुप ऑफ मसल का यूज हो रहा है, ठीक, and sensory loss over the lateral two-third of the palm hota hai. So you got the answer that it is Gwen's canal syndrome, where initially there is pins and needle sensation on the ring finger and the little finger. Later on, no doubt, it will also cause paralysis of the muscles of hypothenar eminence. As well as the 15 out of 12 muscles. और उसमें क्या होगा, अगर पूरी 15 muscles paralyzed हो गई हैं, तो फिर क्या होगा, there will be a partial claw hand. ठीक है, complete claw hand नहीं होगा. Complete claw hand कब होगा, in clump case paralysis, that is through injury to lower trunk of brachial plexus, because median nerve also carries fibers from the lower trunk of brachial plexus, and that innervates the 5 out of 20 muscles of the palm. So this wajah se there will be partial claw hand. Okay, this question. A 45-year-old lady was operated on for the treatment of chronic gastric ulcers that had not responded to medical treatment at operation for partial gastrectomy, it was found that the posterior wall of the stomach was stuck down to the posterior abdominal wall, and the surgeon had to proceed with great care to avoid damaging important structures lying in the stomach bed. The following structures located on the posterior abdominal wall were possibly involved in the disease process, except which one? I believe you got the question. It's very easy. The only thing they are asking here, as a point of anatomy, that what are the structures in posterior relation to the stomach, or structures related in the bed of stomach. So what you have to rule out is the structure which will not be in posterior relation of the stomach. Simple. The choices are the lesser sac of peritoneum, the splenic artery, the left suprarenal gland, the right crest of diaphragm. The answer will be, let's see, D, D, A, C. Oish. So answer is, most of them have written D. Okay, so the answer is hang ho gaya kya ye? Yes, the right crest of the diaphragm is the correct answer. You can see, just a revision, that this is the structures in relation to the posterior surface of the stomach or the bed of stomach. ठीक है? So what you're seeing here is spleen, right? Then you have left kidney, then you have left suprarenal, like diaphragmatic surface, area in relation with the diaphragm, and this will be the pancreas. Remember, anterior to the pancreas, this will be the root of the transverse mesocolon. So the transverse mesocolon will be there, and the splenic flexure of the colon, pancreas, and above to the upper border of pancreas is the tortuous course of splenic artery. So nowhere in the diagram you finding is the right crest of the diaphragm, or right crest of the diaphragm is not in relation to the posterior relation of the stomach. So in the above question, all the structures are related to the posterior wall of the stomach, which includes lesser sac of peritoneum, splenic artery, left suprarenal gland, left kidney, left crest of the diaphragm is in posterior relation. Remember, and transverse mesocolon, splenic flexure of the colon, except the right crest of the diaphragm. So right crest is not in posterior relation. This question is about inferior tibiofibular joint is an example of. सिंपल क्वेश्चन है, जनरल एनाटॉमी का क्वेश्चन है. यू जस्ट नीड टू नो द टाइप्स ऑफ जॉइंट्स, जस्ट टू रिवाइज द टाइप्स ऑफ जॉइंट्स. सो इंफीरियर टिबियोफिबुलर जॉइंट इज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ, लेट्स सी, आंसर टू दिस विल बी, आई कैन नॉट सी द चैट विंडो. एनीवेज, आई बिलीव यू मस्ट बी नोइंग दैट द आंसर हियर इज सिंडेस्मोसिस, राइट? Syndesmosis क्या होता है? Inferior tibiofibular joint is nearly immobile joint. It's a fibrous joint having an interosseous ligament in between the two bones, and such a joint is called syndesmosis. Remember now, whenever the two bones are joined together with the help of a ligament, without any articular surface, without any joint capsule, or without any synovial membrane, just two bones binded together with the help of ligament, it's called syndesmosis. One example is, you can see here, it is inferior tibiofibular joint. The other example is interosseous tibiofibular joint, or intermediate. Actually, you have superior and inferior tibiofibular joint and an intermediate joint, right? Intermediate is because of the interosseous membrane, right? So inferior tibia fibular and intermediate tibia fibular joint. And similarly, in case of radial ulnar, the intermediate radial ulnar joint is because of the interosseous membrane binding radius and ulna. Okay. Then synchondrosis word kya hota hai? It is another name from primary cartilaginous joint. Example, the joint between epiphysis and diaphysis, the apron of femur. And you know that this synchondrosis is the, you know, another name where this cartilage trans, you know, because of this growth plate in between epiphysis and metaphysis, with until there is growth happening and that they diffuse, and that's called synchondrosis, and that's why it's a temporary joint. It does not persist throughout life. And by the way, is there was a word synostosis, if you remember. Synostosis mein kya hota hai? Synostosis is can be, you know, primarily like congenital or might be ankylosis, ankylizing synostosis bhi hota hai. Theek hai, might be like after a fracture, they might, the bones might not be reduced properly. So incongruent surfaces, they get fixed, they get fused. So that also is synostosis, and then can be iatrogenic synostosis, like purposefully when there is comminuted fracture, the bony fragments are damaged so much, you cannot compensate for the bony loss. So you fix up, a wrist or an elbow or a knee or something, you know, such joints where the bone is crushed. So you compensate movement and you fix the bone in a, you know, particular angle. And that also is synostosis, right? Then secondary cartilaginous joint, also known as symphysis, right? So symphysis, synchondrosis, synostosis, syndesmosis, you should have actually clear idea about all these terms. Symphysis and has a pad of fibrocartilage in between the two articular surfaces and is primarily slightly mobile, right? Symphysis pubis, then sternomandibular joint, and the joint between the body of vertebrae. Then plain synovial joint has a synovial, isme synovial word ho gaya. Synovial ke kya hai? Three primary criteria. Remember, synovial joint is a joint which will have, the two articular or two or more articular surfaces. They should be lined by an articular cartilage, that is hyaline cartilage. The another criteria is that the joint should be covered or enclosed in a joint capsule. The third is that in between the cavity, there will be a joint synovial fluid enclosed in a synovial membrane. So these are the criteria of synovial joint. Here you have a synovial fluid lined by a synovial membrane between the two flat surfaces of adjoining bones covered by a fibrous capsule. Now, lots of joints are there. There has to be some varieties, but the plain synovial joints mean there is sliding movement possible. That is plain synovial joint. Example is intercarpal joints. Question number 4. Out of the different factors, which is the main factor that leads to ovulation? The cells of the cumulus ovaricus become loosened by the accumulation of intercellular fluid between them. Right? Ovum, we're talking about graafian follicle. So nearly on the 14th day, the changes that are happening will actually lead to ovulation. The question here is, out of the different factors, which is the main factor that leads to ovulation, right? So one they have mentioned is that the cells of the cumulus ovaricus, right? These are the granulosa cells surrounding the secondary oocyte. So the cells of the cumulus ovaricus become loosened by the accumulation of intercellular fluid between them. Second point is, on the surface of the ovary, an avascular area, stigma, appears over the most convex point of the follicle, and the increased pressure of the fluid in the follicular cavity, which you call as antral fluid. You know, graafian follicle has an antral cavity which is filled with fluid. So there is in the course of 14 days, there is also, this antral fluid also keeps increasing in amount. So because of the increasing amount of antral fluid, there's, on the convexity created on the surface of the ovary, and that is thinned out because, and that becomes an avascular area. Isko stigma kehte hain. ठीक है, सो बिकॉज ऑफ इंक्रीजिंग प्रेशर इन साइड दैट स्टिग्मा बस्ट. देन द थर्ड पॉइंट इज द हाई कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ LH, ल्यूटिनाइजिंग हॉर्मोन, लीड्स टू इंक्रीज एक्टिविटी ऑफ एंजाइम कोलेजिनेज. नाउ दिस कोलेजिनेज विच डाइजेस्ट द कोलेजन फाइबर सराउंडिंग द फॉलिकल, राइट, जहां पे ग्राफिन फॉलिकल सर्फेस ऑफ ओवरी पे बर्ज कर रहा है वहां पे ये कोलेजिनेज एंजाइम जो है उसकी एक्टिविटी को कंट्रोल करता है. इट इंक्रीजेस द एक्टिविटी ऑफ कोलेजिनेज एंड हेल्प टू डाइजेस्ट द कोलेजन. देन द फोर्थ पॉइंट हियर मेंशनड इज दैट द इंक्रीज कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ प्रोस्टाग्लैंडिंस कॉज contraction of the smooth muscles of the wall of the ovary. Remember that the ovary, the capsule in the outer surface, the ovary also has embedded smooth muscle fibers. So because of these prostaglandins, that there is a contractibility created and contraction of the smooth muscles in the wall of the ovary, which shrinks. So because the shrinking of the ovary, that stigma bursts and the ovum comes out. So there are four reasons mentioned, or the four factors rather, which help in ovulation. The question here is, out of the different factors, the main factor that leads to ovulation is. So the answer is the luteinizing hormone, right? The luteinizing hormone jo hota hai, that increases the activity of enzyme collagenase, and collagenase helps to digest the collagen fibers, the, you know, capsule of the stigma. Kuch hang ho rahi slide. So I think most of you have written it is the right answer is C. And iske bare mein ek bar pehle bhi maine bataya tha. So whenever when you come across asking about ovulation, you do not have to think much about, like, you know, all of them. Remember, let me tell you, all of the reasons mentioned here, they do have a role in ovulation. They're not obsolete points. They do have a role in ovulation. But the question was about the main factor. So main factor tumhe class 9, 10th mein, high school mein, 11, 12th mein padhaya jata tha, if you remember. LH surge is the main factor for ovulation. So don't deviate from that fact, that LH surge is the main factor for ovulation. Aur 4 mein se choice mein hamesha LH surge ke baare mein you will get an option, and that will be the मेन कॉज ऑफ ओविलेशन. अब LH सर्च करता क्या है कि वो कोलेजिनेज को एक्टिवेट करता है और कोलेजिनेज डाइजेस्ट करता है स्टिग्मा पे, वैस्कुलर रीजन पे, एंड इट लीड्स टू बर्स्ट. सो एंजाइमेटिक डाइजेशन ऑफ द फॉलिकुलर वॉल सीम्स टू बी द मेन फैक्टर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर ओविलेशन बिकॉज इट कॉजेज एप्रिसिबल वीकनिंग ऑफ द फॉलिकुलर वॉल. हाउएवर रेस्ट ऑल द चॉइसेस आर ऑल्सो नॉट रॉन्ग. Okay, so this also we have done. And finally, the last question. What are isochromosomes? What are isochromosomes? First choice is during zygotene stage of first meiotic division, these come to lie parallel to each other and are closely opposed, known as pairing or synapses. Together they constitute a bivalent. So is this what we're talking about, isochromosomes? Or these are formed by the transverse splitting of the centromere during cell division. These come from both male and female gametes and come to align parallel to each other during the first cleavage of zygote. Fourth point is, these are formed by the longitudinal splitting of the centromere during cell division. Let Let me see the answers you have written. B, B, D, A. A, B, A. I think this must have been taught to you. Remember, you know, what is centromere? I believe you know that. Like, and according to the position of centromere, ye karyotyping bhi hoti hai. They have a short arm or a long arm, P and Q arm of the chromosomes. Then, accordingly, they are graphed in a karyogram, remember? So, and you know what happens during this NR phase, that they split apart the centromere and there is actually a longitudinal cleavage or, you know, separation of this centromere. So isochrome chromosomes kya hote hain? Isochromosomes, those who have written the B is the correct answer, that isochromosomes are formed by the transverse splitting of the centromere during cell division. So what this transverse splitting, what will happen, both the two sister chromatids mein, though jo short arm mein P, they will go to the one cell after division, and both the long arms Q, they will get separated and will be, you know, will collect in a different nucleus. So short arms get separate, long arms get separated because of the transverse splitting of the centromere, and thus these chromosomes are called isochromosomes. Isochromosomes are abnormal chromosomes formed due to transverse splitting of the centromere during cell division. That normally jo hota hai, longitudinal splitting is normal, so that both P and Q arm of sister chromatid, they get separated. But because of transverse splitting, dono P arm, dono short arm ek side, dono long arm goes to the other side. So such that one chromosome has both the short arms and the other chromosome has both the long arms after splitting, and those are called isochromosomes. Okay.